Yes, you love to see it. You love to see that it's now on my hat. So hey, how's it going, members of the Shan Society? And I got another means for the sham, and obviously, I got myself a customized hat with obviously yours truly, the sham, and it's obviously like the profile picture that I have on the YouTube channel, which is me holding Ray. And obviously, like the video's literally right there for the context of it. And yeah, obviously, we're back with some more memes. So this is gonna be volume 29. We're almost close to 30, so that's awesome. And yeah, like I said, now that we're back with some memes again, I don't know what to expect. So let's see and let's jump into this. But before I do that, let me hit that intro.
Time to deliver a
another video by the sham.
We're gonna start with some gansitos or a filled snack cake, which these are good, especially if you put them in the freezer. Like they taste bussin'.
Have you all ever tried a gansito? They're like,
oh, you disgrace me, sir. You don't say gansito. It's gansito. Even if you can't say it in Spanish, just say it like that. That's the right way to say it.
Like chocolate covered cakes in an orange box with like a Donald Duck looking mascot.
Oh.
I am gansitos. Have you?
That hurt me. That hurt me. First calling a gansito and then saying a Donald Duck, obviously like it's a duck, but you know, like ever since I bought these, I never usually like went on to thinking what was the duck's name from Los Gansitos, because I just thought about one thing, eating these in the freezer. Like obviously like I try them like normally, like buying them straight off like that, but they're okay. I mean, they just get melty because, well, it's chocolate. Because, like, it's chocolate and obviously, like, it's gonna get messy over time. And then, obviously, like, if you put it in the freezer, it's a whole new sensation because it's cold, the chocolate doesn't melt, and it just, like, tastes amazing. So, yeah. What a way to sponsor Gansitos for the start of this meme showcase. Yes! We got another Mario Kart race. Obviously the last one I saw was Mario and Luigi, and Luigi won this one, and now it's gonna be Peach versus Daisy. My bet's gonna be Daisy because she a queen. Obviously I respect Peach, but Daisy a queen
versus Daisy.
Come on, let's go. Come on, Daisy. No. Make the comeback! Come on! Come on! No! Oh wow! What a turntable! Obviously, Luigi won against Mario, and now Peach won against Daisy. Damn it! Well, maybe next time. Maybe next time, Daisy can defeat the next opponent. But I guess the props are for Peach. So. Congrats. And it says right here, Scout's POV when encountering the Armored Titan in Season 1. Oh, gosh. Let's see.
Oh, God, it's the Armored Titan. We need to run. Oh, my God, it's the Armored Titan. Good thing we have Aaron. Oh, my God, it's the Armored Titan.
We'll be fine. This.
Oh, my God, it's the Armored...
I'm just... Obviously, like, if you don't know what happened after, like, the progression of that. So... Obviously, like I talked about it, like I made a discussion about it, but I'm probably gonna post it sometimes after this, because like I had a bunch of other videos, but yeah, like basically, like here's the moral of the story is that basically the Armored Titan was terrifying in the beginning, but as the what's it called, the seasons progressed, it started taking L's. And that's why they changed, some people call Reiner, not Reiner anymore, but they called him Liner because he's taking fat L's even against Aaron. Like every freaking battle that he had against Aaron, he kept on losing, and there's no way to come back from that one. Not even if you win the last battles, because like I know that there's we still got one more part for Attack on Titan, and yeah, even if he does something that does benefit and does take a win, you're still gonna be seen as a clown who took a fat L against a person that literally like, you could defeat because you had more military experience. And it says right here, me coming home to my dad. Yeah! Damn! Yeah, that's a Fire Force. Definitely excited for when it returns. Like, obviously, there's still, a wild connection. And obviously, I'm not going to spoil it because I know that some people haven't read the manga. But, I've already heard the spoiler about the manga of Fire Force. Even though, they were saying that obviously it was ending. And now the few weeks happened after that, they said that they were done with the story. And basically, they gave a major spoiler at the end for the people that read it, but the people that didn't read it got a major spoiler after the, and I was one of them. But after I started watching that and Fire Force, how it was going, the progression, and then seeing what they were talking about the spoiler, I was like, oh, okay, I see it. And obviously, like I said, it's a spoiler, but I don't want to give it away until they fully complete the manga adaptation into the anime. But till then, I'm just going to keep that spoiler in my head until we get to that route. But still, fire scene for sure. When he did that one move that made it look like a crescent moon, but a blast at the same time. Oh, he's going to say it. I was going to have to say it.
Best characters from any universe worthy to lift Mjolnir.
Let's see.
Hands down.
List character.
I agree. I'll put $5 on that. I'll put $5 that he has the capacity to lift Mjolnir. Okay, so we see a man with a suit in the beach putting a shell. He probably has something inside there that whenever they put in the ear, it's gonna give him a message. I love that.
You still there? Hello? Hello?
It's like, you still haven't responded me to your car extension service. Do you want to renew it? Hello? And it says right here in the comment section, ignore it. It's a shell company. Love that. Oh, dude. This one hurt. This one exactly hurt. And it says right here, POV, this is just a commercial. And obviously, this is to all the viewers that have watched the show called Chavo El Ocho. And obviously, I'm going to play it. And you see Eugene Derbez.
¿Me sigues viendo como cuando eras niño?
Yeah, dude, this is what resulted in pain because, I remember, as a kid watching the show regarding this character called Chavo El Ocho and, the shenanigans that would happen in his neighborhood. He obviously living in a poor circumstance, but obviously still having a home, which is his barrel. And obviously, he still goes on having adventures with his friends and his neighbors. And it was just a hilarious time. Coming back from school and then my parents coming back from work and then it'll be in the afternoon that this will show up and obviously we would just sit down and just vibe to this show because it was just hilarious and just a good time. And obviously it sucked when I started growing up a little bit and then I heard that the actor that played this character passed away. A lot of people felt so sad. Even I did because this show, shaped my childhood. Like, I know that there were some shows with Cartoon Network, Disney Channel, Nickelodeon, all these other shows. But, like, when it came to, like, the Spanish-speaking channels, and this show came up, like, it was, like, a good time. Like, there's still moments that I, like, reference some jokes that they gave, even to this day. And I'm like, damn, dude. It really has been, like, a long time, and this actor passed away.
Claro, toda la vida. Siempre me has acompañado.
Yeah.
¿Cuántos canales? ¿Cómo han cambiado las cosas?
And obviously, like, this isn't the actor. Like, this is obviously, like, some other person. Like, now we have the capacity that they could, like, facial change a person's character. Like, obviously, this is someone else. And obviously, like, they have the digital capacity to change, like, the face of the person to make it become, like, it was the person that was from the show. To sponsor the channel, and obviously, like, it's just an ad for obviously the satellite company, or not the satellite company, a TV company that obviously gives more channels for the Latin people so they could watch more Spanish speaking channels. And, sí. Yeah,
ahora hay cientos de canales en español e inglés.
I've seen this commercial around a lot. But, like, it still hurts, dude.
Y hasta lo puedes ver aquí.
Chanfle.
Los latinos hemos llegado muy lejos. Nuestras películas ganan premios. Nuestra música da la vuelta al mundo.
And it hurts because, like, obviously, like, he's going on with the fact that he's, like, saying that, damn, like, we evolutionized so much. Like, obviously, like, we have these movies that are big now. We have music that touches the people's hearts even more than before, and all this other stuff. Like, we have accomplished more as the Hispanic community, and obviously, like, since he passed away, he was never there to truly see all the goals that the Hispanic people did, because, like, back then they were quiet, like, there were silence without, like, giving the spotlight. But now that the spotlight is given, like, a lot more stuff is progressing forward. And obviously, like, it sucks, but
hasta hay un servicio de televisión que lleva nuestro nombre.
I really wish that times were like this again.
Los primeros pasos, como tú.
Y como tú.
Para una comunidad latina que crece, un servicio.
Dude, this is the face of pain, dude. And I'm also here, dude. Damn it, dude, this is making me sad.
De televisión que lleva su nombre. Dish Latino. Latino como tú.
Yeah. But obviously, like the term says, even if they're gone, the things that they did in this world stick with us in our hearts. And obviously, like, this show will always be one thing that I hold dear. And it's always hilarious. Like, even though, like, sometimes it shows up in the television, it was still, like, a show to have a good time. Like, not worry about, like, tomorrow, about going to work or school or this other stuff. It's just a show to just let your laughs out and just have a good time. But, damn. But rip. But it was still a good show. All right, but now that we jump into a brighter video, I don't know what to expect for this one, and it says, "Oop, almost pressed an admin, almost stepped on an admin." Oh my gosh, this is another show that is called Pequeños Gigantes, or what's it called, Little Giants, if you want to, like, translate it. And obviously, like, it was like a contest where basically they were showing their talent that they have, or just, like, they had, like, these sequences where they were just, like, joking. It's, like, hilarious. It's almost like a Family Feud with American Idol, like, all combined, but, like, in one thing.
Son respetuosos.
Sí.
Si le dices un nombre, vete, se va. Mm. Pero si le dices un nombre, ven, viene.
I love that. She a queen.
A ver, Mateo,
let's see what the what the kid says.
Se lo llevó Dana, pero tú qué hubieras contestado.
Bueno, es la verdad, no existen, las mujeres los idealizan.
Wait, what did he say, Lucy?
La verdad no existe, las mujeres los idealizan.
Well, damn. Oh my gosh, I just love the fact, like, he was like, you know what, to give you the truth, like, obviously the girl was saying that we as men are respectful, and basically, like, if they tell us to leave, we leave, and if they tell us to come, we just, like, go to them. And obviously, the kid was like, to tell you the truth, women idealize them. They don't exist. I'm like, damn. Trying to throw a shot to every guy. It was like, damn. So all the guys are not respectful. It's just an ideology that is, like, brought up. Damn, dude, that really hurt. What a Chen move, though. All right, let's see. And this is right here. Literally, Stan, no chance. OMG.
All right, let's see if I can beat them in a fight. I'm pretty confident in myself.
Oh, it's a fight. He got all of the top characters from cartoons. Obviously, Yakko is also another one. Like, even though he may not look strong, that goofiness that he has is strong enough. You also got Samurai Jack, Yoda, and Superman. At that point, just, like, let them be on their side. Be on their good side.
All right, let's...
Rip. I don't know who I would get. I kind of want to do this, but at the same time, I don't. It says right here, please post that one. I find the voice so cool and creepy at the same time. What? The bird does a creepy sound? It's raining, it's pouring, I'm telling you, like, these birds have freaking awesome qualities. Like, obviously, like, back then, this was just me. When I saw a bird, I was just like, oh, it just chirps. It flies. And there's different species of it. But now that as I grew up, it's so crazy the fact that there's a whole variety of how it goes. Like, obviously, like, what I found interesting was basically, like, the social experiment that they made, where basically they got 5 of the same birds and they leave it, like, in, like, a jungle, I think. And obviously, like, the 5 birds, like, go their own separate ways. And it's, like, awesome, like, how it goes, like, with the fact that they don't all stay the same. They all evolutionize to, like, different species. Like, obviously, like, one could have, like, a bigger beak because, like, they lived in a niche where basically, like, their seeds are, or their food source is bigger than anything. There's also ones that they have shorter beaks. Like, they evolutionize based on the environment that they grow up in. And, like, that's what's awesome. And also the fact that there's some birds that could mimic, like, what they hear. And also that one bird that I saw from one of the memes for the sham that basically, like, it could do the sounds of pictures or the chainsaw one. And I'm like, yo, these birds freaking are on another top level. Like, I want to learn more about these birds and what other birds have qualities interesting like this. Like, obviously, like, this bird is literally copying a song and also chirping at the same time. Pretty awesome. And it says right here, it records your voice?
Yeah, the PS5 controller will record your voice if you have the setting turned on, and it leads to you getting some pretty uncut reactions.
Oh my god, one fucking... Die! No! Hey, no!
Okay.
Oh my god, I have 1 HP, so is he.
Oh, whoa.
Oh my god.
Okay, so I still have, I have Elden Ring, and obviously, I'm gonna be playing it very soon, so stay tuned for that. And obviously, let's see how I'm gonna react when I play it for the first time. Like, will I react like this guy, where I go like that? Will I rage? Who knows? It's all gonna be a freaking special field day when I get to that route. But I didn't know that. Like, obviously, I know the PS5 has settings that could, like, hear what you gotta say, because, like, it has, like, a little, like, speaker right here, I think, or something like that. I don't know as much of the qualifications of, like, a gaming controller, but I do know that there's a button that you could share, like, a clip, which is, like, very resourceful, and this one has a mic, but the Xbox doesn't. So that's a one up. Hey, so we see here someone is gonna make ice.
Yummy!
So, oh my god, the comb broke.
Oh wow, that's amazing. Okay.
Oh my god.
Oh my.
God.
Oh my.
Damn, what the
heck is
happening?
Okay. Okay. We'll just get one.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's see.
We're gonna put in a little bit of brownie.
Uh-huh.
A little bit, that's a whole thing.
Uh-huh.
That's a whole bit.
Somebody.
Yummy!
So, oh my.
No! Bro, the fact that she was, like, trying to look for the perfect bowl, being that literally, like, all the ones that she's been getting were all broken, until she got the broken one, she literally broke it again, trying to scoop up the ice cream. Like, obviously, like, you put the bowl down, then you scoop up the ice cream, because, like, if you do it one-handed, then the possibility is that you're gonna hit the bowl, and you're gonna screw it over. So, kind of not a smart plan, but yeah. All right, this person is his lookalike. Let's see.
Come on, who we got? Who am I? Who am I? Who?
He's Ed Sheeran.
Oh fuck, I see it.
I'm in love with the face of you, oh or shape God. Of you. Shit. Well, he can make a banger. He can make the remix of The Shape of You, because he has the looks. That's awesome. I wonder who I would look like. Don't answer that question. So we got a Minecraft video.
Oh, dude, how do you make a diamond pickaxe? It's not working.
I think you use a hoe or something, but come here and look at my fishes.
All right.
Fishes?
Where at?
Oh, they're over here.
Yo, that light's cool.
yeah. But I named all of these. This is James, Jackson, Joseph, Julian, Jack.
What's this room right here?
Don't go over there. I want to tell you all my names and my feet. I told you don't go in.
It's gonna be like something.
What the hell?
Don't go. Damn, this man has culture in a room. Wow. I knew that there's, like, modifications that you could do to give you, like, some stuff in Minecraft. Like, there's some mods that obviously could give you, like, a server where basically everything is, like, so difficult that you literally, like, can't pass the game at all. Or can't even progress forward, more to say. But I never saw this one where basically, like, you could, like, customize your own, like, paintings, like whenever, like, you have, like, the crafting to make a painting, and obviously, like, you can make it, like, customizable. I did not know that, but wow, this man had culture in his room. And this is right here: when you want chicken in a Mexican household but forget it's a Friday. Oh yeah, basically, it's gonna be the time of, what's it called, it's the time of the month where basically, I don't want to get it wrong, but it's basically goes with religion, basically, that we can't eat any meat on Friday. It's almost like a restriction that basically, like, we don't eat, any meat for Friday. Like, it's every Friday of, like, April, because, like, we're commemorating the resurrection of Jesus. And I think it's right, because obviously, don't quote me on this, but I think that's where it goes, because of Easter and obviously the resurrection. And yeah, like I still remember the fact, as I was like growing, like I still remember one Friday and when I was like little, I was like hungry, and obviously like I found meat and I started eating it. And then like my mom was like saying, like, what did you eat today? I was like, oh, I ate this and that. It's like, did you eat the meat? I was like, yes. It's like, oh, you're not supposed to eat meat on Friday. I was like, oh, why? And then she gave me a little explanation. I was like, oh, okay. And like now, yeah. It's a restriction, but it's just for the month of April. And yeah. But that's how it is in a Mexican household. Oops, I forgot to literally play the video. Let's see what happens. Oh, the mom was like waiting. Oh, the blue shell. This is Mario Kart. No. Yoshi. He's gonna get the backlash. He got the backlash. No. Damn. But is Yoshi gonna win? No way. But he was all the way in the back. Oh, here comes Bowser. Oh, damn. Still Toadette won in the end. That is a goated car. If it could withstand the blue shell and then come back on its feet and win the race still. Gosh, and this is right here. You could commit crime in the new Kirby game. Oh, gosh. Oh! No way. Tell me this is real. Or, shit. Tell me this is not real. That basically, if you, like, obviously, there's a mode that basically you have to collect all the Waddledees. It's like the special bonus that you would get at the end. And I didn't know that you could literally do that. That basically if you have like a weapon and you were to struck violence to the Waddledee, you literally kill it. bro, Kirby a demon then.
Fact.
Okay.
Reality series River Monsters ended because star Jeremy Wade was able to catch essentially every exceptionally large freshwater fish species on Earth, leaving no remaining content for the show.
Wow. Well, that's literally a fact that I never knew. Like, I remember, like, on a Discovery Channel that they would, like, always showcase, like, the show where it's him. River Monsters, basically, it's already there. That he goes on to, like, these places and he just, like, fishes these fish that are just, like, ginormous. And I'm like, damn, dude, like, this man, like, knows, like, the techniques to, like, catch a fish and then, like, showcase it. But I didn't know the fact that that's why, like, there's no more show of this, because, like, he already caught everything. Well, damn. Well, what's next for him? Nobody knows until he gives off a interview saying, oh, this is going to be my next goal now. Now that I fished every large freshwater fish species, here's the next one. But fun fact, and it says right here, I'm fucking balling.
Oh, I'm just wondering, can you still hear me?
Yeah.
Swear to God. can I get number 11?
Damn, dude, the... like, the menu looks so big, and then you just see the freaking, the to-go window is all broken. Or the to-go speaker box. Damn, dude. And it still works. That's still pretty amazing. Oh my gosh. Y'all are demons. Trying to hypnotize these frogs. Like, I remember in shows that they were hypnotized frogs, and it supposedly does something to them. The hell's that? Kill John Lennon. Oh my gosh. the freaking South Park clip. I was just so stupid. Wait, he had something. What was that? Y'all are so freaking dirty. What the hell, dude? Bro, you could get freaking arrested for that if you get caught. What the hell is that?
Just in the middle of nowhere, actually nipped in. These are shopping carts.
Oh shit, that's all shopping tied together. Cart? How? And who had all this time? Bro, who had all this time to literally say, you know what? I'm going to go grab all the shopping carts and I'm going to freaking combine them together and make them look like a freaking unique stuff in the middle of nowhere. Wow. Well, this is a discovery for sure. Oh.
Save you'll ever see.
The best save. Oh. Damn! He literally slipped, but still managed.
The best save.
He still managed to, like, literally save his car from it, driving away and getting totaled. Damn, what a save, dude. Oh my gosh, leave Mario alone! He's going down the goalpost. He's not doing that freaking... that shit, dude. Leave him alone, jeez. Oh my god, I can't believe he's actually gonna answer this question. He's like, W human?
Let's see. I like this. It says W human.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm old, so this made no sense at all. So I
replied, exactly.
I don't understand that.
Uh-huh.
And several people said it's okay, actually, it's a good thing. W for win or winner. So basically they're saying they really liked the video and that I'm a winner.
Yeah, like, obviously there's some W people in this world. But then there's also people that are fucking L's. You know who the hell I'm talking about. We're talking about those Karens, bro. Like, obviously, like, I don't like whenever, like, some person trying to do a good action. And then, obviously, like, you see these L's, like, walk around. And they're like, I don't appreciate what you're doing. Like, who gave you this? And da-da-da-da-da. I was like, bro, I'm just here to literally help out. I'm literally here doing this, and they're obviously there just to freaking make it worse, like make the day worse. But in reality, we have W humans and we have L people also, or W and L humans together.
I love the generational gap.
Yeah.
When I was your age, our grandparents lived in a different world.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm one of the grandparents. I look on your world with great fondness. It's amazing.
Hey, I do love that. But obviously, like, since he's already, like, how he was saying, in the grandparents' age, obviously, like, he's gotten wiser, and obviously, like, yeah, that's just the wise ideology of how they see now the future just growing. Obviously, like, it was all different for them, and now, like, now technology is, like, growing. Obviously, people are evolutionizing. Like, we have freaking TikTok now. Like, this TikTok. We have trends. We have these, like, current events that are going on that are just, like, goofy. And then sometimes they're, like, something that's just, like, an amazing discovery. Or even, like, tragedies and all this other stuff. Like, there's a lot of stuff. And obviously, yeah. But he's a W human for sure. This is right here, falling asleep anywhere as a child. Oh, yeah.
No need to take the main roads. I know a shortcut. There we are.
That's true. I remember the fact that that whenever my parents were invited to a party, like, I would always, like, get tired and literally fall asleep on the chair where they were sitting. And then, like, out of nowhere, I'm like, huh? Since when are we in the car? I was like, bro, what the hell? And then I sleep again, and I was like, I'm in my bed. What the hell is going on? Like, where's all this transportation going in? I'm scared. I have powers. But obviously, like, it's just them moving us. And then this is right here. Talk about 10,000 volts going down your back. I thought I could pick him up without feeling his wrath. Someone please help. I've never been body slammed so hard in my life. Please get some ice. What? Obviously, this is a... Oh! It's a jellyfish. But obviously, like, he is fine. It was just a little shock that the jellyfish gave. It was obviously, like, it says right here, it could result in injury. So there was a warning. So obviously, YouTube, do not take it as a freaking sign of violence or self-harm. He was just giving a self-explanation of what happens. And obviously, like, he is fine and he is recovering from this.
This hummingbird just landed. I don't know. Here he is. He just landed. Oh. I don't know what he's doing. He just laid here. He's laying down. I don't know. Should I touch him?
He's stuck. You gotta help out the bird.
Are you okay? Dave, oh my god, oh my god, are you okay? Are you okay?
Are you okay?
I've never seen a bird do this before. Are you okay?
Is it, are you okay?
I got you.
Let's see. Oh, he's gonna poke.
Okay.
Water?
Here we go. Want some water?
Let's see.
I have water.
I have water. No! He's like, fuck.
Poorly planned. Sir? 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 Can I... Do you need lift a hand? What's up?
He's like chilling.
Here you go. Drink it. Please don't die. Please don't die. Please don't fucking die.
Come on.
Go. Yeah. Yeah. You're fine and stuff now.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, you're covered in... You're covered in, oh wait, okay, I see it. You're covered in spider webs.
Oh.
You can't fly. You can't see anything. Fuck. I have to be in doctor mode now. Okay.
Dude, but like, the hummingbirds are very, very delicate because like they're so, buddy? Like they have wings that go fast.
What's up? He has it all over his head. You can see it. It's on his beak.
Jeez. Bro, poor hummingbird.
Fuck your head up.
Look at all the spider web. And it's stuck on him. Damn. Never seen a hummingbird this chill.
Can you see now? Can you see now? Is that better? Is that working for you?
Yeah.
I know I'm yanking on your body. I know. I'm sorry. It's really tangled up in there.
Helping you out.
Are you just hanging out? You are such a pretty bird.
Pretty bird.
Yeah.
Pretty bird.
Hey, W bird for literally chilling.
Feeling better? Yeah. Okay. I gotta go to work now. See you, buddy. okay, so this
bro, W Bird, for literally like not freaking out every time that the guy wanted like to take off the spider web, and W Guy for literally like helping out these birds because like obviously like they're very delicate because obviously if they get caught in spider web then that's it, like they're screwed because like they have fast wings or they flap their wings so fast that even in slow motion it's like. You always say, whoa. But, like, obviously for the naked eye, you just see them, like, flap it, like, freaking fast. And I'm like, damn. But still, W humans, like the guy was saying, W humans. Like, we have W tendencies, but also there's also L tendencies that come out of this.
Yo, some tell scotch. Me this doesn't sound like when you're building some shit in Lego Star Wars, bro.
Yeah. It's already like you're going and then the studs come out. Yeah. Damn, now I want to play Lego Star Wars. Damn, dude. Alright, and this is going to be the final one from one section of my friend sending me these memes. And this is right here, me finding something weird on my For You page. Right to my friend's DMs. Oh my gosh. Like, obviously, like, this is the inner machinations of my friend's mind that basically, like, anything that he finds, he's like, immediately, let me send it to him. Let's see how he reacts and all this other stuff. Like, yes, there has been some videos that this friend has sent me that I get so questioned. I'm like, what the hell is he getting sending this For You page? Like, obviously, my For You page has, like, variety now because of these videos that I get sent. And, yes, there's some gold ones that even I like from it. And so stupid. I was like, bro, like, what is this For You page even going to? It's going to evolutionize into something so weird. But that'll be it for my friend sending me these memes. And obviously, like, I got one For You page, like, meme of the day by yours truly. And let's see which one I decide to choose to showcase. Okay, if I had to choose one from the Life For You page, it has to be this person. Obviously, when I first watched this person, I was like, bro, the cringe that would come out of this for certain people. But obviously, like I said, I'll just let them be how they are. And obviously, this person has a lot of energy for sure. And doesn't care for what happens first with the people around.
First, we need to go to a place where new daddies frequent. The baby section. Mm-hmm. Does anyone want to be my daddy? Goo Gaga?
I love the fact that this guy was like, bro, what the hell is going on? I was like, I don't know. I don't get paid enough for this. But okay.
Daddy? Well, no daddy's here. Time for the next stop.
Lowe's.
Hora loves hardwood, so we're gonna look in this section.
Oh my god.
Can you say daddy issues in Spanish? I can't find a father figure anywhere.
Grab and go. Oh my gosh. And obviously, in one way it's cringy because, like, the way that she goes like this with this persona from Dora, but instead of Dora, she calls herself Hora. And obviously, like, the goal of trying to find a father figure. And obviously, like, it, like, obviously this is just them being them, because, like, they don't care, like, what they do. It's what they do. And obviously, like, this person does have a lot of energy and really, like, props for the fact that you don't feel embarrassed after these videos.
We did it.
Well, we got a win. What the heck? Okay, but that'll be it for this meme showcase. Obviously, I definitely enjoyed some of these. Like, I learned some stuff. And we got some wise advice from an old generation saying that we are W humans for sure. And obviously, like, we're just a W generation going forward. And obviously, like, in some cases, I do agree. In some cases, I don't agree. But, hey, we humans. And obviously, like I said, that'll be it for this video. So stay tuned for more videos like this and other ones. Don't forget to drop a thumbs up for the video, and also drop a subscribe for the channel and one for the gaming channel that I have. And I'll see you all in the next one. All right, laters.